What's going on, everybody? GamerSci back with another video. Now here we go with the third video in just over a week, I think. I don't know who I think I am, RetroTech 100 or somebody maybe. But anyway, you've probably heard me mention on this channel before the Sinclair for Sale website. It's a Facebook page, trading page, a lot like a lot of the other ones out there. However, great community feel, good prices. Sinclair collectors trying to do each other, you know, a decent deal and bargains to be had. Anyway, there's one fella on there by the name of Dean Wakefield. Dean, if you're watching this, thank you very much, my man. And he's always selling loads of stuff. Like, he's always got tons of Sinclair games for sale, multiples of the same ones. I think he ram raided Clive Sinclair's garage, to be quite honest. But anyway, a little while ago, he had a big listing up, and it was multiples of each title. And I just said to him, look, I'll take one of each, because he was asking 50 pence per game. So I was like, right, 50 pence a game. I'm at work. I can't check which ones I've got, which ones I haven't got. I'll have one of each. So the cool thing about Dean as well is he builds you a little pile, and over the month you can add more and things if you want. And at the end of the month, he sends you your invoice, you pay him, and he sends you your games. So I can't actually remember most of what I ordered. I can remember like maybe two games out of this. And anyway, this box arrived today. All I've done is I've hidden my address. And I haven't opened it yet, so we're going to have a look, because I really can't remember what I ordered. So yeah, this is going to be a ZX Spectrum tape unboxing, not unlike what you'd find on David Bursell's Retro Games Played Badly channel. Probably not as slickly done as our Yorkshire colleague, but yeah, so it's a yellow tail. I think that's wine, isn't it? Anyway, let's have a look. Let's see what ZX Spectrum awesomeness we've got. Let's see, I honestly can't remember, but it should just be one of each. Right, okay, here we go. Here we go, here we go. Right, so first up we have Cassette 50. Bit of a legend in the world of the ZX Spectrum Cassette 50. It was 50 games on one cassette. From what I've heard, they are pretty poor. I don't have a copy of this, I know that much. So, yeah, we're off to a good start. So, I'll do a David Birdsell, and I'll just put it over there like that. There we go. Right, next one we've got is that Pterodactyl. Four-dimensional graphics reaching out of your 48K spectrum. What? Never heard of it. Melbourne House, I remember them. I'm sure they were responsible for the god-awful version of Double Dragon the Spectrum got. Okay, let's keep going. Formula One Simulator by Monstertronic. Now, I'm sure the aforementioned David Birdsell got this in his last package. So it rings a bell. It's Monstertronic. It's for the $1.99 range, which all of us old Spectrum, Amstrad and Commodore 64 owners will remember very well. You'd take your pocket money every week, you'd buy a $1.99 game. 9 times out of 10, it'd be rubbish. But occasionally, there were some gems. So, okay, I'll have that over there. Right, what have we got? Alien Destroyer. Now, I haven't played this, but that cover, those graphics there, are Galactic Plague from the Amstrad. So I wonder if this is the same game, just on the ZX Spectrum. I wonder if when they took it to the Amstrad, they renamed it as Alien Destroyer. So obviously Amstrad did end up owning Sinclair. Maybe. We will find out. Speaking of Amstrad, Oh Mummy. Very much known as an Amstrad game. But yeah, there is a Spectrum version. It's not as good. It's a bit more basic. The Amstrad had a bit more going for it. But top game. Little bit like Amador, if you've ever played that. Alright, what next? Sky Ranger, the Monstertronic game. Nope, never heard of it. Give it a go. The ZX Spectrum Plus User Guide Companion Cassette. Whatever. Okay. What's we got in here? Ugh, there's one. Right. Oh, these are classic old Sinclair games. Crazy Golf. I think I'm going to play this on my friend's Sinclair back in the day. Back in the day, I had an Amstrad. My mate had Sinclair. He had the Plus 2. I'm sure we played this. Peter Gallagher was his name. Right. I think we'll play this as well. Treasure Island. Those are all by Mr. Micro. Does anybody know who Mr. Micro is? No idea. But I don't have these, so it's good to get them. 50 pence a go. Visions Snooker by Tim Bell. In fact, it works on the 16K Spectrum. Isn't boding well, but I suppose how advanced does a snooker game need to be? Oh, here's a one. Punchy. Focus. Punchy, I'm sure Punchy was, I remember the name, I'm sure it was like a Hunchback clone. Or something like that. Again, it's another one of these original Sinclair games. Were these bundled or something? The way they've all got the same kind of look would make me think they were. Probably bundled with the Plus 2 or something. Steve Davis Snooker. Steve Davis, the most interesting sportsman in the world, obviously. Another snooker game. I have one Spectrum snooker game when you can have two. Great, what have I got? Okay, here's that one. Disco Dan. Again, it's a game I've heard of, but I don't think I've ever played it. No idea what it's about. All right, stick it over there. What else have we got in here? See, I'm sure when David does this, he uses a fixed camera. Swish bastard. Right, Viper 2. Animostronic $1.99 game with no screenshots. None of these tapes have got screenshots. I again don't know. I don't remember playing Viper 1. Never mind Viper 2. Was there even a Viper 1? Nice artwork though. Right, next. Ah, now I do know this one, Joe Blade 2. I did like the Joe Blade games when I was younger. Can't remember much about the difference between them. It's basically this kick-ass little fella fighting your way through. Yeah, that'll... Joe Blade 2. That'll get played. Right. Shanghai Karate. That's about as generic as you could expect. I do have some screenshots though. They don't look bad for a Spectrum, do they? Enter the Dragon Temple, but first you must reach Shanghai. Take on the role of Yao Lin in this, the ultimate martial arts experience. Features two-player action. Okay. All right. Shanghai Karate. Oh, we've got a Quattro pack. Quattro Adventure, featuring Vampire, Ghost Hunters, Super Robin Hood, and... I can't get away from mentioning David Birdsall in this video, can I? But David, look, it's Dizzy. Dizzy was I've mentioned him before on this channel. He was the quintessential British video game mascot, invented by Codemasters. David Birdsall is a huge fan. Any Dizzy merchandise you can find, send along to his channel. He loves reviewing it. It's kind of his thing. But the Oliver Twins' greatest creation, Dizzy. Pro Golf. Yeah. Checkered flag. It's an early ZX racing game, funnily enough. Getting screenshots. I think I've got that one, actually. Kobayashi Naru. Now, I may be wrong here. Is that something to do with Star Trek? Is that that test that Kirk cheated on to pass because it was impossible or something like that? I haven't watched Star Trek in a very long time. But do you want to be the immortal? As it happens, there are a few vacancies at present. So you could be in luck. Take the Kobayashi Naru and the job could be yours. Complete the three quests to succeed. Don't think about failing. Be warned though, a typing test it isn't. So it is about a test. I'm sure that the name at least is taken from Star Trek. I'm sure it is. But that appears to be some kind of bat freak and a silhouette. Yeah, no idea. We'll find out. Next. Sinclair ZX Spectrum Chess. It's a chess game. Sinclair ZX Spectrum VU3. What? VU3D. What, is it like a 3D rend? Can't be. VU3D is a design and modelling program in three dimensions. From an image in the mind, create an object on the screen. It's 3D rendering software for a 48K spectrum. That's fantastic. Okay. Tomcat! Okay. Guess I'm writing the fame of Top Gun. What sort of... Appears to be some kind of horizontal... Sorry, vertical shooter. That one might be alright. Okay. More... The Empire Fights Back. You would never get away with that now. Disney will probably bum rape me just for saying that. The Empire Fights Back. Okay. Don't tell us what it's about, just give me loading instructions. Next time I buy games, I'm going to have to make sure they've got bloody screenshots on them. Just what we've got. Ah, Soul of a Robot. This is one of those games, I remember as a kid, I used to see this in video game shops. Where I was growing up, there was a one called Livewire in North Shields. And one in Newcastle called, creatively, it was called The Computer Shop. And I used to see this, and I just think it looked cool. Oh, it still doesn't show anything. I think the artwork looked cool, Soul of a Robot, but I've no idea what it's about. Again, it's one of those Mastertronic 199 games. I think I used to see it on Spectrum, but I had an Amstrad, so I couldn't get it. That must be why. Oh well, that's this one actually, yeah, that one's getting played because I'm curious about that. Okay. Only a few left. Spectrum Chess. Because I've got that chess game, so I might as well have another one. And another great chess game. Another. Because, you know, you can never have too many great chess games. Right. Getting quite crowded here. Right. What's last few? Rapid Fire. With, honestly, that's not Sly Stallone. Honestly, Governor. How did they get away with this? Right. Okay, I've got some screenshots here. Let's have a look. Kind of hard to tell. Doesn't seem to be a lot of shooting going on, to be fair. Looks like a bit of a ninja-y game. Okay. Well, rapid fire. Now this one I know. Los Angeles SWAT. Now I had this on the Amstrad. It's like a vertically scrolling like Commando, Ikari Warriors type game. It's not as good as them. There you go. You know, you troop up the screen, you shoot, and you throw grenades to take out the terrorists. That might be fun to try again, though, being I haven't played it in 30 years. Oh, well, LA SWAT. Spacewalk. Okay, I'm thinking more fun things to do. Obviously, it's one of these Malstronics, so I've got no screenshots. Let's have the Lou idea in, you know. Wouldn't show you what the game looked like. This went, Lou, look. Nice graphics here. You can't see them, but look at the picture on the front. It's only $1.99. I can't tell you anything about that because I've never heard of it. And there's no screenshots. Spacewalk. Can walk itself over there. Now, as well as them, like I say, what he does is this Dean Wakefield fella, he will just he'll put them in a pile, and over the course of the month, he can just say, oh, I'll take that one as well, mate, I'll take that one. You'll build up a pile, and then at the end of the month, he'll send you a little invoice. You pay, and he bangs the games over. So I got all of these in the one listing. Say they were 50 pence each. And then towards the end of the month, he put up another listing where he had a few games for £1 each. So I grabbed a couple of them. And these were the big box games. So I got Power Drift, which is the Sega arcade game. What's it doing? And the cheeky blighters appear to have put the arcade graphics on the screenshots. Like the ZX version is going to look anything like that. I've not played the ZX version of Power Drift. The Amstrad version was alright. I think the Commodore 64 version was decent as well. But yeah, Power Drift, £1, can't complain. And then I also got another one, another big box for £1, and it's Ninja Spirit. Now, this rings a bell. I think it was an arcade game. Atari ST screen shown. So that's of no use. If you know the difference between the Atari ST and the Sinclair ZX. But yeah, it's some kind of samurai type thing. It does ring a bell. Early 90s, I think I remember seeing this in computer magazines and stuff. Ah well, cool. So anyway, yeah, and I've dropped one. An absolutely huge lot of games, and on my teeny little table here that usually hosts my Amiga, it's absolutely now chock full of new ZX Spectrum games. I'm gonna get playing a few of these, I think. Big shout out to Dean Wakefield and the guys on Sinclair for Sale. Thank you very, very much. And very sorry to David Birdsall for stealing your shtick. Big fan of your channel, mate. Thanks very much. Anyway, I've been GamerSci. Keep ahead.